ராஜராஜேஸ்வரி சந்நிதியில் உட்காந்துருக்கோம். சத்துர்புஜே சந்திரகலாவதம் சே குச்சோன்னதே குங்குமராகசோனே புன்றே இக்ஷு பாஷா அங்குஷ புஷ்பபானஹஸ்தே நமஸ்தே ஜெகதேக மாதாஹ ஸ்ரீ ராஜராஜேஸ்வரியை நமோ நம. லெட் காடெஸ் ராஜராஜேஸ்வரி பிளஸ் ஆல் ஆஃப் அஸ்.
வி மெட் திஸ் ஆகஸ்ட். Yes. When we were introduced to the great Pudhuvudai Murthy and his system, ALP, Akshaya Lagna Paddhati, you have been practicing since then. What do you think are your experiences? Have they been favorable? Have you been able to make predictions far better than you were able to do before? What do you think are the plus points of the system?
I have been practicing for about 45 years. The Krishnamurti system, which is famously known as the KP or Krishnamurti Paddhati. Using the Krishnamurti divided the star into 9 parts and named each part as the sublord. And he gave the clue that sublord leads to a clear cut prediction, and I have been successful as a KP astrologer. And to my great amazement and surprise, I met Sri Pudhuvudai Murthy sir by a great chance. I happened to see him on the YouTube, and the moment I heard about this Akshaya Lagna Paddhati, which he calls ALP in the diminutive, opened my eyes. Oh my God, a person with a great knowledge has come about something phenomenal and explains very clearly the happenings in one's life using astrology as a tool. Then I went through his YouTube. He has divided 120 years of the Kala Purusha, on which the Vimshottari Dasha is also based, into clearly 10 years for each Rasi. Thus we reach at 120 Rasis in a lifespan, a total lifespan of manhood. Using his principles, how he has explained the Akshaya Lagna Paddhati and what are the mathematical principles he has given to this world, opening the eyes of all the astrologers, giving something phenomenal to this world in knowing what the divine has in store for us. My sincere thanks and reverence to Sri Pudhuvudai Murthy in this concept. He has clearly established that 10 years for each Rasi, the progression is per degree it takes about 4 months. So for 30 degrees of a Rasi or a sign, it takes 10 years span. 4 into 30 degrees is 120 months, which we divide by the 12 months per year, we get the 10 year period. Remarkable. So using this technique, I studied my own horoscope and found landmarks in each of the end of 10th year period. So to say, the balance I had, because I was born when Lagna was rising at 24 degrees and the leftover in Sagittarius was only 6 degrees. So multiplying 6 degrees by 4 months for each degree, I got 24 months. So 2 years closes my Sagittarius period in this world. So 2 to 12, it enters Makara, and I could read my horoscope, the placement of the planets in my horoscope. This 2 to 12, the 10 year period, was I could interpret very clearly, more clear than the Krishnamurti system, using the Sri Pudhuvudai Murthy's concept of ALP, Akshaya Lagna Paddhati. Akshaya means the growth of Lagna, how the Lagna grows after the birth of a child. So each 10 year period, the life of the child is impacted. So thus I could find very clearly the impact of the 10-year period in each Rasi, progressing from Makara to Kumbham, Aquarius, from Kumbha to Meenam, Pisces, then 32 to 42 in Mesham as my ascendant, Aries, that is Mesham, then 32 to 42 Rishabha, that is Taurus as my ascendant. All the other planetary positions remain the same, originally as it was available in my birth chart at the time of my birth in Pudukkottai. But the variance is vis-a-vis the Lagna changes, and when you read the planetary positions using the current Lagna of a particular person, the it Sri Murthy's concept opens a very clear picture in front of your eyes, and it becomes a very handy tool for the astrologer, just out of hand you to give predictions very easy. I salute his methodology, I salute his knowledge, and salute his gift to mankind.
So as per you, based on the age, the lagna progresses. So where is your current ALP?
Yeah, my current ALP, as I told you, for each degree it takes 4 months. So for a 30 degree span, it takes 4 into 30, 120 months, so 10 years. So when I was born, my ascendant was at 24th degree, so the balance in that ascendant, that is Sagittarius, was 6 degrees. So 6 multiplied by 4 gives 24, that is 24 months. At the end of 2 year period of my age, Sagittarius ended. From 2nd to 12th year, it was Makara or Capricorn. 12 to 22, it was Kumbham or Aquarius. From 22 to 32, I was in Meena Lagna or Pisces ascendant. 32 to 42, it was Mesham or Aries. Then 42 to 52, it was Taurus or Rishabha. 52 to 62, I was in Mithunam, that is Gemini. Now I have completed 62 years of age, and my reckoning is Kataka Lagna, that is Cancer. And vis-a-vis all the planets originally in my horoscope, if I read my chart using the ascendant as Karkataka, the future God has got in store for me, it is very clear. It's open cards.
So does that mean that here the least count is 10 years because you are only taking a design? Or is it as per the nakshatra, or it can go even deeper than that?
Yeah, it is 10 years span for each Rasi. For each Rasi or a sign, 10 years. In this 10 years, Sri Murthy sir has distributed this span for the asterisms in each sign, that is nakshatras in each sign. Let us say in Karkataka, you have got Punarvasu, 3 degrees and 20 minutes. Then you have Pushyami or Pusam, that is 13 degrees 20 minutes, the entire constellation. Then another 13 degrees and 20 minutes is Ahilyam star. So you for degree, it takes 4 months. So vis-a-vis you calculate for each nakshatra points or constellation points.
So from what I know is for every quarter it takes 1 year, 1 month and 10 days.
Yes.
So
yes.
For each quarter of a nakshatra.
Yes, yes.
So you can go to that level at the base level itself.
Yes.
The accuracy of predictions.
Yes.
How do you compare this with KP?
Yeah. See here, when you see the ascendant and you progress the ascendant, as per his, he has given 4 months per degree. When you progress, you enter each constellation and the nakshatra pada, divisions in a nakshatra. So this gives of the this is the basis or the foundation of your horoscope. Impact this the planetary positions in your horoscope. So together they give the result. So I have found this methodology has made my prediction very easy and very simple without straining my brain, without straining my energy.
Now, once you have the progress lagna, what is the use of dashas?
That's
how
what
you will actually sync the two.
Yeah, you sync the progression. Read your dasa bhukti as you read in any other system, but taking the current ascendant. So that becomes the focal point, that becomes the central point, and all other remains, your predictions of the dasa bhukti remains the same. He has not touched that, but he has moved the exact where you stand now vis-a-vis others. He is the invention of Sri Pothuvudai Murthy.
One nakshatra takes about 1 year, 1 month, 10 days. But I have seen him giving predictions to say what you will be doing in the next 5 minutes, next 45 days, next, you know, this thing. How does he do that?
Yeah, I think still I have not come to that level. He is taking each how the as the lagna progresses. You have fixed a 10 year period, and then you have fixed 4 year, 1 month for each constellation. Then you have subdivided further. So he must be breaking down further into mathematics, which I think he has developed a latest software into that. He will be exposing to the world at the best time he thinks fit.
How does he use the transit as well? How does all these things sync together?
Yeah. He uses the transit also. So he takes your favorable transit. that is Visarga the Akshaya Lagna Padhati. Now am I clear that Akshaya Lagna Padhati ascendant is fixed? And you read the various planets in your chart from the current ascendant, from the current Akshaya Lagna. The old Lagna is forgotten. The present Lagna is taken. The old Lagna is not totally forgotten, but the for calculation purpose that also is taken, but mostly the chief focal point is Akshaya Lagna. Because you cannot get outstanding results if it's not found in the original birth chart.
Right.
So this is a progression. Now, but your life changes as a child grows into a boy and manhood and later into old age, the circumstances change. So this Akshaya Lagna Padhati tells you where do you stand today, what is your scenery today, what is your environment today, what is your relationship today. So he touches the current pulse, the current moment of a person. Then he takes the transit also. The moment transit also clicks. Take the transit also, because transit cannot be ignored. He takes the transit. In my own case, every year I have found remarkable changes, as he said. The changes in my life happened according to Akshaya Lagna Padhati, entering different signs. I told you from second year, it has started moving into another Rasi. So I questioned him, why at 62 I feel there is something is not happening. It has happened all these 61 years. Then he says the transit. The Saturn has to move from there. The moment it moves, things are getting clearer. So we cannot ignore the transit also. Transit is also an important arm in the hands of astrology and also in the Akshaya Lagna Padhati.
So what happened in the key changes at 2, 12, 22 for you?
Yeah. Oh, you are asking a personal question.
Yeah.
And it's also relevant because it impacts anybody.
Yes.
Because it's a common tool given to mankind by Godhead. God has given a tool, what is in destiny for you and what has God decided for you in terms of the Indian philosophy of Karma Siddhanta. So here, from the moment I completed 2 years, 2 to 12, since it went off in my childhood, I don't remember much. But when I look back, after knowing a system, after learning a system from Sri Podhudai Murthy, I could find that there was something clearance, something good happened to me. It was very clear. The reading of the birth chart was as something deep in the ocean, but the waves were not there. The sky was clear, the water was clear, so I could see what was lying beneath. So Akshaya Lagna Padhati was like a telescope in my hand to read what was underneath in the ocean of life. I could see some important. At the age of 12 to 22, it's a great change. My father was transferred from Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh to Tamil Nadu. So there was total different circumstances, change of language, change of environment, total political system was different here. Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh was known for its turbulence, for all the religious and communalism problems read in Andhra Pradesh. Here we found entirely different circumstances, totally change in the environment. From 12 to 22, I could likewise, when I was in my education career, at the end of 22, I entered a government service. It was very clear, very clear. Then 22 to 32, there included as per my Dasa Bhukti also. When I impact the Dasa Bhukti on Akshaya Lagna Padhati, my marriage took place. The Dasa and Bhukti Nada were relevant to the marriage. They were well connected to my marriage houses. And when I read from the Akshaya Lagna Padhati of Meenam, I could see the Kalatra Karaka and the Dasanada in exact positions of giving the marriage. So both put together, it was very, my marriage date was coming up very clear. Even now when I go back 30 years behind and as per applying the Akshaya Lagna theory principles, it is very crystal clear when my marriage happened. And who the girl I married, vis-a-vis from the Akshaya Lagna, the seventh lord, had a definite connection. Mercury, Meena and Mercury, my wife belongs to the, she is a Virgo, she is a Hasta star. It's very clear, sir. It's like an open book. Akshaya Lagna Padhati is reading your future from an open book. He gives you a book, in fact. It doesn't give you a theory. It doesn't give you mathematics. He gives you open book. Come on, read this. Here you are.
I have seen him give predictions where he clearly says the nakshatra of the spouse, the nakshatra of the children, the names of the spouse, the names of the children. Have you been able to reach that level yet?
I am in the beginning. I restrict myself to the application of his principles. And reading. In fact, this has never happened to me, telling the names or finding out where do you live, is there a school or college beside your house, is there a hospital, all these things. This is something phenomenal what he has come out with. He tells you the entire vicinity of your house. Where do you live? Is there a pond? Is there a church? Is there a temple? Is there a Durga temple? He is phenomenal. He is in the mountain. I am just at the entering slopes of the mountain.
I can tell you my experience, you know, when I was first introduced to him.
Yes.
He asked me, what's your lagna? I said, Kumbha. Then immediately he did calculations. He says, what's your marriage date? I gave him the marriage date. He says, timing is wrong. Correct the time. Then he says, immediately you will say that, okay, your wife has to be this, she has to be 1+1, she will be this Rashi or this Lagna, and your son will be named Prashant. I was totally taken aback because I had not heard anybody, just by giving one marriage date, correcting the time immediately.
That is his signature.
And also telling me that my son will be born 1 year later and he will be named Prashant itself, and his nakshatra will be this, wife will be this nakshatra. And in her family, there will be 1+1. That is one herself and her brother. And I was wondering, how are you able to do that? And that's when he clearly told me, it's all from my ALP. Don't look from the natal lagna, look from the ALP. Then I started asking him more questions and he was very nice to teach me some of the principles. I too have been applying and I have been finding really remarkable results. But of course, we have got a far way to reach his level where he's able to tell everything in and around the house. How many kobans of your father, how many are living, how many kobans of your mother, what are the names and other things. I have also seen some YouTubes of his and some interviews of his where just by the name and the age, he is able to give predictions.
Remarkable, remarkable, yes. And using his principles, I know a businessman in Pondicherry. He belongs to Gemini ascendant, Mithuna Lagna. Then he is nearing about 60 now. So his current ascendant is Dhanur, or Sagittari. By the strength given by him, by the hope and confidence he has given me, and practicing his system, I would have at least seen roughly, though I am not practicing much, don't do it as a business, even then easily out of interest, for academic interest, I would have read at least 100 horoscopes based on his theory. I told that businessman, forget that you are a Gemini man. From here, you are a Dhanus, you are a Sagittari. And his entire, because over the years, he got children, got married his children, got grandchildren. So his face, his outlook has changed. He has become a grandfather. From Gemini, he has traveled so much for nearly 60 years. He has become, so all that you can define a Sagittari man.